Hello, and welcome back to my Samurai Jack Retrospective. I'm your host, That Minnesotan Guy. Well now, we've reached Season 2, so let's jump right in and review Samurai Jack Episode 14, Jack Learns to Jump Good.
We start this episode with Jack defeating a horde of Beetlebots and finally reaching a time portal.
At last, my quest has come to an end.
A standard opening for the most part. But what happens next is quite unexpected.
Not so fast, Samurai! Your efforts are in vain, Samurai. This gateway into the past is forever. Beyond your reach! Samurai.
To be honest, it is pretty funny when Aku does that. Man, Jack was that close! Another time, I suppose.
We cut to Jack in a forest enjoying his dinner, but then someone steals the food.
Jungle hobos? I thought they were driven to extinction years ago!
Jack chases down the man, only to be smacked by a branch. The man then apologizes for what he did.
Sorry.
It's all right, Jack. He doesn't seem very bad to me. This character is referred to as the Monkey Man or the Wild Man. No, seriously, I looked it up. Though I think that is probably not the right name for him. I mean, sure, he acts like a monkey and jumps like an ape, but I need something stronger to suit him. Now, I hope no one sues me for this, but I think I'll call him Tarzan. I'll make references to Tarzan, but not in clips from the various films about him. Sorry to disappoint you. I don't know. You're just a nameless entity that I can talk to every now and then. Anyway, back to the review.
What sort of creature are you?
I'm a man like you.
I have never seen man fly.
I know fly. Jump good.
I have to admit, introducing Tarzan this way is just right. Right from the start, we are getting to know his personality and what special abilities he has. Though I have to ask what Kala and Kerchak think of this.
Jack asks if he can learn to jump good, and Tarzan takes him to the tribe.
The shots of Tarzan jumping through the forest, as well as the jungle music, are just a great use of the setting. I'm telling you, Genndy's craft as a storyteller is very noticeable. One more thing, it switched from night to day in that one cut. I guess time fast-forwarded itself. A call that sounds like a mixture of dog and wolf. You know what? The iconic call would have been too obvious.
A tribe of apes gathered to meet Jack, and Tarzan gives us his backstory. Long ago, a large deforestation machine was making its way through, and Tarzan was one of the human slaves. He noticed an ape and freed himself of his collar. He became the tribe's new member and over time learned to jump good.
A good backstory. Very similar to another ape man, only without the death of parents from a leopard and whatever else the character had to go through. Despite that, I like Tarzan so far. I must ask, however, shouldn't the machine have gotten a tighter collar to keep children from escaping?
Jack and the tribe eat a meal comprised of fruit. Suddenly, a flock of birds signal that danger is approaching.
The difference between the two tribes is something I really like. Based on their appearance, I can say that Tarzan's tribe is a great representation of chimpanzees. Chimps are usually viewed as gentle creatures that live a peaceful life and are in some way very protective of each other. The rival tribe is obviously gorillas, and they represent fear, intimidation, rage, and power. If that wasn't subtle enough, then I don't know what other way to put it. What? It's the best that I can come up with. You cool with that?
Jack threatens the gorillas, and when they ignore him, he attacks using bamboo. The gorillas flee, and after the tribe come out of hiding, Tarzan explains who the other tribe is.
We peaceful like flower. Know not how to protect ourselves. Other tribe take food, smash home, never leave us alone! We pick up pieces, replant somewhere else.
I like how this explanation gets you to care for the tribe. They clearly have been through this before, and you just want to see them free of their problems. Well, guess what? You get just that!
Jack offers to teach the tribe how to fight, and in return, they will teach Jack how to jump good.
That was a great moment right there. This does, of course, happen throughout the rest of the series. Now you're going to get two great montages, so I hope you're all ready for the positive things that I have to say.
Let's do it.
Jack helps the tribe set up traps, one of which involves luring a big cat into a pit. He also creates weapons for them and teaches them how to use bamboo as sticks.
This montage has a great use of jungle-themed music. Here's the sample for ya. Another thing to take from this montage is how the apes catch on very quickly to what Jack teaches them. It's great to know that these ape characters are not only lovable, they are also very smart. But enough about that. Let's get on to the next montage.
Let's do it!
The tribe attaches rocks to Jack's arms and legs, and he even has to carry a large rock behind his back.
For this montage, the music is put to such great use that I feel you should hear it for yourself. Here's the first sample. It fits with how Jack struggles at first, but you get a sense of determination as well. Here's the second sample. Now for the final piece. These samples of music fit with how Jack has become better at the art of learning how to jump good. Trust me, your ears will not regret it. Thanks for reminding me that.
Jack is freed of his bonds, and he jumps good. The music in this part represents his triumph.
This episode never ceases to amaze me. Just from these montages alone, you get the sense that anything is possible. In order for anything to be possible, you have to make it happen. This is very important to remember.
Jack and Tarzan say goodbye to each other and wave back. Later on, the gorillas return, but Tarzan and the apes are ready.
Gorilla may be strong, but chimpanzee is smarter.
Using everything that Jack helped them build, the tribe overpowers the gorillas. This action sequence is very fun to watch and shows that the tribe is no longer afraid of their enemy. I especially like how the big cat helps them out.
Apes! Together! Strong!
With their new skills, the tribe gets the remaining gorillas to feel weak and they are trapped in a vine. Tarzan force-feeds them and tells them to never return.
Tarzan. With these new defense strategies, you should be able to defeat Clayton and his men.
Jack watches the tribe's victory and heads off knowing that he has helped more good souls.
Remember back when I reviewed episode 7? In that review, I talked about how the selected music could be used when a badass character defeated a large amount of enemies. It's used very well here. The music can also be used for a scene showing carnage, but we'll get to that within the next few episodes or so.
Jack heads for the same time portal, but Aku shows up again. The episode then ends like this.
Beyond your dream,
you can fly?
No, jump good.
Wacha!
Aw, man. I wanted to see that fight. Why did they cut it? Well, it does end the same way. Jack fights Aku, Aku destroys the time portal, and Jack heads off to find another time portal. Though I have to ask, why didn't Aku destroy that portal after the first encounter with Jack? Why did he keep it as leverage? Was it just to taunt Jack? The questions I bring up while doing these reviews. Yes, so that was Jack Learns to Jump Good. Great animation, fun action sequences, memorable music, lovable ape characters, and a great setting make this episode great. Over time, this episode became a part of my personal favorites. Not much else to say, really. I think I've covered everything today. Join me next time when I review episode 15. Now, I'm sure you all get the idea of why I do these videos, so from now on, I'll say that I make this show for fun. I'm That Minnesotan Guy, bringing you all quality entertainment since 1996. Or is it 1986? I don't know. I'll see y'all next time.